On average, a recruiter only looks at your resume for 6 seconds. And in today's video, I will teach you how to write a UX design resume that impresses a recruiter in 6 seconds. Regardless whether you have real-life UX design project or not, this video is made for you. First thing first, I will challenge you to forget about your old resume and then think about writing a new one for 2023. Let's open up a Google Doc and let's get started. Please use this structure regardless how much UX experience you have. Your basic info on top, experience as the first and as the main section, skills as the second section. You can copy exactly what I have here. Education as the last section, and you don't have to explain your education. This structure helps you to brand yourself as an experienced designer. Type this down in a Google Doc. Now for the experience section. Please first brainstorm what have you done in the past, especially what you've done in UX design or product design or anything that brought you to UX or product design. Now remember, regardless how many experiences you have working in the past, choose 4 most related experiences only, quality more than quantity. You shall prioritize the most recent user experience design real life project and bring that to the first. Real life project means that you worked on a project that actually got built or you worked in a team as a user experience or product designer. If you don't have a real life UX project, what you can do is bring your personal project at first, but it has to relate to user experience design. Now, if you don't have any user experience design related project, nor design related project, then I don't think rewriting your resume shall be your current focus. You shall spend more time on learning user experience design, product design, and then try to do 2 or 3 personal projects. But you are still very welcome to watch until the end. For the experience header, you can simply put UX designer at blah, blah, blah. The blah, blah, blah can be the company name or your project name. So here, what I had is UX designer at Keys. Keys is a startup name. UX design intern at Lucky Bamboo. Lucky Bamboo is a company name. UX designer at Mama Book. Mama Book is a personal project name. And UX research intern at Stanford D School. For the last one, I chose a UX related experience, and you can do the same to put in your most recent job experience or other types of experience. Underneath each header, putting where you did the job, putting the location of the experience, and then the time frame of the experience, and make sure it's chronological. Now I will teach you a super simple brainstorming technique I use when I try to think about what bullet points I need to put for each experience. So on the Google Doc, just putting before what I did and after, and then just brainstorm and dump everything about what is the company like before you are here into the before section. And then under what I did, brainstorm some points about what you actually did during the internship or during the experience or during the job. And then under after section, brainstorm what was your company like or what was the project like after you finished the experience. Let me first give you an example of a personal project. This one is for Mama Book. So before I started this project, there's nothing, because personal project, you take things from 0 to 1. There's no product, there's no Mama Book. I also did this personalized project because I realized there's not so much customizable journal for people like me who like writing journals. What I did during the project, I initiated the project, that's for sure, it's my personal project, and I designed a responsive website by Adobe XD that allows users to customize a physical notebook. And I finished the entire user flow for customizing a notebook online. I did 3 rounds of user testing on around 5 participants. I did a competitive analysis. I did sketches, wireframing, prototyping. I presented the idea online on YouTube. And then I managed the project all by myself because come on, I'm the only person doing the project. Now for the after part. This is actually really hard for personal project, but you still have to say your impact regardless whether your product is launched or not. So here's what I thought of. At least I got some great feedback after the user testing, and I generated some views on YouTube that can count as user interest or product exposure. And that's it for this brainstorming session. Now I'll teach you how to turn this into this. All you need to do is to compare what is before and what's after to figure out your impact. And then combine one impact point with one action point from the second what I did part. Start this bullet point by choosing an action verb that best describes the action you did. And also bring in one number. This number will be great if it is on the impact. It's okay if you don't know the exact number, and it's okay to estimate the metrics. For example, my first bullet point is, initiated a project that helped journal writers to customize their personal journal online that generated 283K plus user interest. So the impact here is that I generated around 283K user interest, and then the action I did is initiated the project, and the number I use is on the metrics. And remember, we are writing the phrase, try to bring one detail about the product you were designing for, so that it doesn't sound like this bullet point can be copied from another designer's resume and then directly pasted here. Here, I specifically mentioned journal writers, which is the target market for my personal project. Another example for the bullet point, design a journal customization user flow under 4 months for a responsive website using Adobe XD through sketching, wireframing, prototyping, and user testing. Here, the action verb I chose is designed, and the impact is finished designing this customization user flow. I don't have a number to bring here, so the trick I did is bringing the number of months I did the project, and the technical words related to UX design that I used include sketching, wireframing, prototyping, user testing, and Adobe XD. The third point I said is conduct user experience research with a focus group of 5 to iterate on early design concept that led to 28% NPS increase. The action verb I used is conducted. The impact is 28% NPS increase. The action is I did user experience research. The numbers are 5 and 28%. And then the UX keywords are UX research, focus group. And here, NPS means net promoter score. It's a very popular metric that measures how well do people like your product. All you need to do is ask on the scale of 1 to 10, how likely would you recommend this product to your friend? And final bullet point I said is manage the project using the Agile development framework to assure efficiency and quality delivery under 4 months. Action verb, managed, impact, deliver the project under 4 months. Action is manage the project using Agile development framework. And the keyword is Agile development framework. You need to frame your personal project in a way where it sounds like you are an entrepreneur. Instead of like you are inexperienced and beginning this field, you cannot find a real life experience at the moment, so you did something on your own. Now, if you have a real life UX project, keep watching because I will show you how to write about a real world UX project. First, brainstorm what is the company like before you're here, then brainstorm what you did in the experience, and then brainstorm what was the company like after you left the job. Let's say I did an intern at this company called Like the Bamboo. So before I was here, the company has a horrible outdated website. Company does not attract the attention of Gen Z audience. The company is experiencing a decline in the website visiting number. And what I did is that I did user research and competitive analysis. I redesigned the entire website. The wireframing prototyping is in Figma. I created a design system. I collaborated with the founder and the software engineers. And then I worked with the front-end engineers, provided feedback to code out the website. What happens after is that we relaunched the website and then generated more Gen Z interest. Increase the retention by 22%, increase visitors by 23%, especially younger audience, and increase company sales by 25%. It will be great if you can get these numbers. If you cannot get these numbers, get whatever numbers you can, and if you can't get anything, just estimate it. Now we need to turn this into this. Again, let's take one impact, one action. And then when you're writing this paragraph, start it with an action verb, bringing one number and bringing some UX design related keywords. So for the first one, increase the company website visit volume by 23% by redesigning the website to adapt to mobile devices and incorporated a modern aesthetic through 2 rounds of sketching, wireframing, and prototyping. The impact is increasing the visiting volume. The action is redesigning the website. The first action verb is increased. The numbers are 23% and 2, and the keywords are sketching, wireframing, prototyping. Here, another trick I did to add another number is to include how many rounds of iterations you've actually done. Second point, attract Gen Z audience through upgrading to a more modern branding and creating an expandable design system of 80 plus elements that aligns with the new brand guide. The impact here is attract the Gen Z audience. The action is building a design system. The action verb is attracted. The number is 80 plus and the keywords are design system, brand guide. Here another number trick I did is to include how many elements are in the design system. Third point, improve the website retention rate by 22% by introducing a stronger design hierarchy that simplifies the user flow for customizing a product. Impact here is increased retention. Action is introducing a stronger design hierarchy, and the action verb is improved. Number is 22. The keywords are design hierarchy and user flow. Finally, collaborate with the product manager and the front-end engineering team using the Agile development framework to ensure quality delivery under 4 months. Here, the impact is deliver the thing under 4 months. The action is collaboration. The action verb is collaborated, and the number is 4. And the keywords are Agile development framework. And the trick I did here is bringing the number of months that I worked in the project as the number. I will give you another example for UX real life project. This is for if you're designing for apps. So UX designer at Keys, before, what I did after. It's listed here, and then I turn this into this. Pause the video if you want to read more carefully. Now, if you don't have enough UX experience to cover all 4 experiences as UX-related things, you can bring 1 or 2 other experiences. So here's an example. You brainstorm what's the company or the project like before you were there, after you were there, and what you did during the time you were working on the project. And the trick I did here is to actually emphasize on how this relates to UX design. So what I said is that I brought significant insight to the UX design team. And if you just can't figure out how your past job relates to UX design, what you can also do is to highlight your soft skills, which are collaboration skills, management skills, leadership skills, and communication skills. So do this for all the 4 experiences that you want to write in your resume. And once you are done, you can make a copy of this file and then delete all the brainstorming bullet points. And the final step is to polish up the visualization of your resume. And you don't have to go fancy. It's perfectly fine to use Google Doc. I actually recommend you to use Google Doc just in case the companies you're applying to use those digital resume reading tool that actually might not read 2 columns design very well. Here's the key, fit everything on one page. Minimum font style to use, 11 pixel. You might need to decrease the page margin a little bit, and you can fit date and work title into the same line. And please keep your background as plain white. And if you want to gray out certain elements, you can do it, but make sure it's still accessible. I've seen some resume where they just look a little bit too transparent that I can't even see it. And boom, here you go.
Nice.
And whatever I said here worked for me, and I really hope that it will work for you as well. If you have any other tip, please leave a comment in the comment section below. And if you like this video, you will also like this video that's coming up next. I am Aliana Tsai. I will see you in this video. Happy New Year!